Having an engaging website is one of the best ways to keep people scrolling on your site and keep them going page to page. Because at the end of the day, if people stay on our site, they're more likely to check out our services, our work, and eventually make it to our contact page. So when we're thinking about how to actually do that, one of the best ways to add a little bit of movement, a little bit of intrigue, and keep people scrolling is by doing sticky scrolls. Hey, I'm Jessie from Inkbot Creative, and we are a brand and web design studio that helps photographers who want to stand out, create a brand and a website that really does just that for them while also showcasing their personality. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to do two different sticky scrolls, one with text and one with images, to help give your site that little bit of boost, that little bit of intrigue, and keep people scrolling. I'm going to walk you through the exact settings that you need to know to actually make this happen, but I'm also leaving a link in the description below that has a share key for these exact canvases. So you can add it to your website and then adjust it and update it for whatever you need for your specific content. I'll make this super easy for you, so be sure to check that out in the description below. So without further ado, let's dive in. So we're going to cover two different sticky scrolls. The first one is going to be text and the second one is going to be images. Now with this, my suggestion and how I do this is I will create the section as it's going to look at the end. So once everything's on there, that way I can make sure everything's spaced correctly and then I can duplicate canvases and actually create that sticky scroll. So to do that, the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to come in here. Let's add a heading here and let's just say canvas heading. So we have this here. We want to make sure this is kind of the thing that sticks to the top, right? Everything's going to scroll underneath this. So we have the canvas heading. Now let's say I want a little box and that's what's actually going to have all of the text. Let's switch this to a different color. Okay, now I'm going to have a subheading here. We'll make this white. And then I'm going to have my paragraph content here. So we have this set here. This can be whatever you want it to be. We can, you know, write anything that we want, whatever this is, maybe your service. So this is your services sections. We have, you know, wedding photography services. And then we can say maybe weddings, elopements, engagements, whatever it might be. So we can put the main kind of service here, and then we can put a little blurb about what that service actually is right here. Now, what I would suggest doing once we have this is flip over to mobile and set this up on mobile first. So we have these sections here. Let's get the canvas up here. Canvas heading, get that centered. Now we'll pull this here. Have the subheading up here. And then the paragraph right here. Okay, so now we have this set up. We'll make sure everything's centered. Make sure everything's centered on this. And we have our different options here. Now, once we have this, we can go ahead and duplicate this. So I can copy and paste this. We'll align it to the center. I can do it one more time. We'll bring it up here. So now I have the three canvases that I want with the three different services. We can make these different colors. Maybe we switch between this and black and blue. Okay, so we have the different options here. This is what it's gonna look like at the end of the scroll. So once all of the options are here, we have this. So what I want to do now is come over here and we can actually duplicate this. Now for mobile, you don't necessarily have to worry about switching it. Obviously we have three canvases now on desktop and we still only see the one on mobile. Since we're only, once we actually do it, we're only going to have the one canvas on here. It's okay that these are all stacked this way. We more so want to have desktop split up so that we can see where everything lays and make sure everything's centered. These are going to go on top of each other. So it's a little bit different. So once we have this, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to duplicate this canvas. Now on this second canvas, I don't need this heading here and I don't need these two. So this is going to be the first one. We'll go ahead. We'll come up here. We'll duplicate this again. We can come down. This one is going to be the second canvas, right? The second box. So we have this one and then we'll duplicate this one more time. Bring it down to the bottom. This one's going to be this box, so we can go ahead and delete all of that. So now we have these sections here. I can come up to this one and I'll go ahead and just remove these. So now what's going to happen is when people first land on it, it's not going to show anything. So it's just going to have this title with nothing there. Then as they scroll, this one will come up, this second one will come up, this third one will come up. So that's how it'll kind of happen there. Now to actually make that effect happen, the first thing I would suggest doing, I like putting this as window height just so that there's no background on it. We can go ahead and make these window height as well, just to make sure everything is the same size. And then we want to make sure that this one is sticky. So we have sticky right here. We want to put top on scroll. That way when someone hits this canvas and we get to the top, it's going to stop and be sticky. For these, we also want them to be sticky to top on scroll. Now there are some times where you don't want this if you want everything to just kind of keep going and disappear. But for these, we want them to stick so that people can read them. So I'm going to make sure all of these say top on scroll, top on scroll. Now the final thing that we want to do is make sure that the actual stacking is correct and that we don't have backgrounds on these final images, these final canvases. So we want this background to stay the same. We want this white background. But for these, we don't want a background on these because if we do, it's actually going to cover up what's here and it's going to cover up the subsequent canvases. So we're going to come over here, canvas background. We're going to make this transparent. Going to do the same thing here. Transparent, and then finally transparent. So now we have that. The final thing that we want to do is just that stacking order. So this one is going to be the bottom canvas. We want everything to go on top. So this is okay to stay at zero. For this one, we want this to be one. We want this one to be on top, so we'll do two. We want this one to be on top, so we'll do three. So now these will go on top of each other. Now, in order to continue this and continue the rest of the page, when we add a new canvas, so we'll do heading, just next canvas. We want to make sure that this canvas has a higher stacking order than the ones above it. So we ended at three for this one, right? So our stacking order is three. We want this one to be at least four so that it goes on top. And then every other canvas underneath this needs to be above three so that we don't have this one come back up, right? Since this is sticky on top, if we have something, if we add another canvas here, that's only two. Let's change this background just so we can kind of see what happens when that happens, right? So if I were to preview this, I have this one here. We scroll and we get our canvases coming up, right? That one comes up. But since this one's lower, this one that we just added, now we see this box again. That's not what we want. We don't want that box to come back. So we need to make sure that everything under here is above the stacking order of our last sticky scroll canvas. So that's what it looks like. We can come over here. Let's preview in a full tab. So we have the canvas here. This one's going to stay sticky. This one comes up and stops. Next one comes up and stops. Third one comes up and stops. And then we have the next canvas that continues up, right? All of the future canvases on the page will go down there and the page will continue to scroll. So that's how we can do that sticky scroll. Now, if you don't want the first one to show up blank, so say we don't want this here, we want something here so that people can see something right off the bat and they don't feel like there's no info there, we can take this first option, put it on this canvas. We'll go ahead and hide this one completely. And now as we look at it, we have this one first. So as we scroll down the page, these two will show at the same time. And then we have this one come in and this one come in. So depending on what you're looking for, if you want something there to begin with, or if you want everything to kind of scroll, you can adjust that and have either something showing on this first one or something not showing on this first one. But that is how we're doing the actual text scroll if we want something like that. If we're looking at it on mobile, what's going to happen is these will continue to scroll on top of each other. So there are times where sticky scrolls might not work on mobile the same way they work on desktop. You have to understand that when we're doing this, the length of the canvas can only be as tall as window height on a phone. If you have more content than that, it makes sense to not have mobile be sticky and just have this scroll normally. So thankfully, since we can split things on desktop and on canvas, when we have this canvas type and the sticky, we obviously have it set on desktop as top on scroll. Right now, this is none. So this isn't going to scroll. So we can adjust that to be different on desktop and mobile, depending on what works and how long your content is. Again, you might be able to make it sticky on scroll on desktop, but it's just too long on mobile. We don't want information getting cut off. Now, another option that we have is to do something with images, to have images scrolling. So this is one where you might want it where the images actually keep going. And so they disappear. They don't actually stop like we see with this, where we want these to stop so that people can see it. With images, or even sometimes some pieces of text, you might want it to just keep going. So let's take a look at what it would take to do that. So let's add a heading here, and maybe we say my favorite wedding images. So we have this here. Maybe we want this in the center of the page. Now, with something like this, you might also want the text to be a little bigger. So this might be somewhere where you're like, actually, I want this to be really big. Let's go here, even this out, get it in the center of the page. Okay, perfect. So we have that. Again, I'm going to go ahead and make this canvas window height just so that we have it there. So we have these, our title here. This is what we want to be sticky. This is what we want to stay. I'm going to come in here. Again, I like to do this beforehand just so that I can actually adjust and see where everything is going to kind of land and scroll. So let's go here. Let's add another one down here, maybe. Let's add another one down here. Do another one here. And it's okay if they go off the page because this second canvas is going to be bigger. So we're going to have more stuff to actually put in it. Let's go there. Make this one a little bigger. Okay. So now we have these in here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to duplicate this canvas. I'm just going to delete the text because we don't actually want the text on here. And then I'll come in here. We'll get rid of all of these. So now we have the canvas here with the text. And then we have the images that we have after. I can go ahead and make this one bigger so it encompasses all of the images. Perfect. Okay. So what we want to happen with this one is this canvas is going to stick. All of these are going to continue to go over it and just keep going. And then we'll have another canvas at the bottom that'll just be a canvas that follows it up with our next content. So add next canvas. Have this here. So again, we want to make sure that this one has a higher stacking order than everything else so it goes over it. So this one we can go ahead and keep at zero. This one we want to make one. And again, we want to make sure this one's transparent. And this one we want to make sure is at least two. And for this one again, we want this sticky to be top on scroll. So now if we come up here and preview it and we open it up, we have this that stays here. It's going to get sticky. We have all of these images that come up, and then we have the next canvas that follows it, right? So there is one other thing that we can do. We notice as we do this, the images actually go over the text. There is a way to do it if you want the images to go behind the text. So in order to do that, we're just going to adjust one thing. We're going to take this canvas here. We're going to add a blank one that goes right beneath it, and we're actually going to make this canvas 1 pixel. We're going to have this one be a little bigger. We're going to take this canvas and we're actually going to adjust the stacking order. So we're going to make this 2. That way it sits on top of this color block. And it also is higher than this one. So this one's set at 1. It's still going to go over that color, but now it's going to go under this text. And then this one, we just want to make sure is still set higher. So we're going to set this to 3 just so it covers this as well. Now, the final thing we want to make sure is we want to make sure that both of these canvases are sticky. So we have this one top on scroll. Let's make this one top on scroll. So now if we preview it, we can come over here. We have the images there. And if we look, they scroll up underneath. So now instead of going over the text, they go under the text. So that's one adjustment you can make depending on if you want it over or under, but super quick and easy. You can do this with anything too. So we can have this be text. We can have this be images. You can have this be icons, whatever it is that you want. You can put anything on this sticky scroll canvas and it'll keep going. Hopefully this helps and you can create an incredible sticky scroll section that really catches people's attention. Again, in the link below, you can find the share key for these sticky scroll sections. You can add it to your website and customize it really quick and easy. If there's any other features you want to learn about, be sure to drop it in the comments below. We'll make a video on it going over exactly how to do it. We can't wait to see the incredible options that you make with these sections. And as always, if you found this video helpful, be sure to hit that like and subscribe button, and we'll catch you in the next one.